Before we start, I would like you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to Celeb Dirty. Here are 10 celebs you forgot competed on Fear Factor. Number 10, Nicole Snooki Paluzzi. Snooki and her fellow Jersey Shore star, Dina Cortez, appeared on Fear Factor years after their Jersey Shore days. They called themselves Team Meatballs during the game show to represent their short and curvy appearances. According to Grunge, during one challenge, the Meatballs played a spin the bottle game involving creepy crawlers and landed on a crab, a millipede, a hornworm, and a scorpion. They were tasked with moving the creatures with just their mouths and succeeded in moving three. Unfortunately, after the scorpion bit Paluzzi's lip, she gave up.
I'm up and say, you know what? I can do this stuff.
Oh my goodness! Look at Snooki go!
The biggest grenade. Becky Guerrero? Oh. She's not a diva.
Number 9, Donny Osmond. Donny is Marie Osmond's famous brother who's a singer and dancer like his sister. Out of all the competitors, you wouldn't think that he would be the one to do scary things, but he turned out to be kind of a daredevil. According to Grunge, in 2001, he squared off against rapper Coolio, Baywatch stars David Hasselhoff and Brooke Burns, WWE star Joni Lohrer, and actress Kelly Preston on Fear Factor. Osmond tackled every challenge with excitement, including one in which he had to put his head in a box filled with centipedes, millipedes, worms, and scorpions.
And I'm the interviewee, you're the interviewer. That's a pretty big difference right
now. Yes.
Number 8, Allison Sweeney. Allison is known for playing Sammy on the soap opera Day of Our Lives. She handled most of the challenges pretty well, but one of them made her completely freak out on camera. According to Grunge, Day of Our Lives star Allison Sweeney went on the show in 2002 with the aim of proving that soap stars were tough and not divas. But there was one challenge that scared the heck out of her. She was tasked with moving white snakes from her torso into a bucket of worms scrolling over her legs, and cockroaches covered her face. Despite her freaking out over that challenge, the rest of her time on the show showed people she's not a stereotypical soap opera actress.
After I was done with the challenge, then I had to sit there and lay down with those cockroaches on my face while they removed the snakes.
You have to stay in there until all the snakes are out. You can't just...
Number 7, David Hasselhoff. David Hasselhoff has been a famous celebrity for decades and is one of the most recognizable people on TV. In 2001, he appeared on Fear Factor, and one challenge involved collecting as many flags as possible on top of a moving bus. Before entering the competition, he told the audience in the video you can see on YouTube, "I'm going to win because if I don't win, my kids will think I'm the biggest wimp in the world," according to Grunge. The famous celeb spoke too soon and only got 4 flags out of 13 he needed for the next round. His daughter, Taylor, competed on the show 16 years later, though, to try to redeem the family name.
Tienes que levantarte. Levanta, levanta.
Number 6, Lil Yachty. Lil Yachty just started gaining fame a few years ago, but became even more popular after he appeared on Fear Factor. In 2018, rapper-singer Lil Yachty's challenge involved corralling some turkeys, and all he had to do was wrangle some of the Thanksgiving dinner favorites and move them from one cage to another. It doesn't sound too challenging, but for Lil Yachty it was quite difficult. At one point, he was able to get one into the required cage, but only after making some suggestive hip thrusts in the animal direction, according to Grunge. That's definitely an interesting way to get a turkey into its cage.
Cool. Yeah, I got a future in turkey herding.
Yes.
Let's see if you got it.
Yes, sir.
Oh. Green light. Next emoji. Bullfrog.
Number 5, Stephen Baldwin. Stephen's less famous than his brother and even his daughter, but fans loved seeing him on Fear Factor in 2001. They got to see a side of him they never did before, and according to Grunge, after he was covered with thousands of night crawlers, snakes, and Madagascar hissing cockroaches, he joked that his manicure had gotten ruined but was calm and cool and didn't miss a beat. In his final challenge, Baldwin had to use one of several keys to escape from a shark cage and successfully swim to the surface of a giant swimming pool. He did so in a whopping 24 seconds.
I think he lasted that long.
Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
So my wife, who... were...
Number 4, Kevin Richardson. You might not know his name, but you may recognize him from the iconic boy band, the Backstreet Boys. On top of performing with the band, he starred on the show and beat some other celebrities. According to Grunge, Richardson compared his feelings about the challenge to butterflies before going on stage for a concert. He wasn't afraid of heights, but felt a lot of pressure to win. Thick commented that if it was a boy band record for the number of flags on a skyscraper. Richardson got 4 flags, more than Baldwin, who stopped at 2, and more than Hasselhoff, who fell during the task. Number 3, Pauly D. Polly worked with his fellow Jersey Shore alum, Ronnie Ortiz Megro, who's also claustrophobic like him. That fear didn't stop them from beating their other Jersey Shore co-stars and the other contestants, though. According to Grunge, the duo competed alongside fellow Jersey Shore alumni Nicole Snooki Polizzi and Dina Cortez, as well as four stars from the show Floribama. On the last challenge, the guys had to descend from a helicopter and rescue a dummy by attaching it to the helicopter co- The Jersey Shore pair rocked the task. Number 2, Allie Landry. Although Allie was Miss USA in 96, she proved that pageant girls can be fearless. She had no problem scaling the 36-story building in the 2002 episode. And while she found bugs crawling all over Body Freaky, she didn't break down like fellow contestant Allison Sweeney did. Landry was fairly calm throughout the challenge, commenting afterwards that the worst part was the sound of the hissing cockroaches, according to Grunge. She got far into the competition until she lost to Stephen Baldwin during the final shark cage challenge. Number 1, Ludacris. Ludacris didn't participate in any of the challenges, but he started hosting the show a few years ago and helped shape it into what it is now. When MTV revived the series in 2017, the network replaced Joe Rogan with rapper-actor Ludacris, who also executive produced the program. The show changed its focus slightly, avoiding challenges such as eating disgusting insects to more playful tasks that resonated better with Generation Z viewers, like coping with a waterlogged smartphone, according to Grunge. The famous rapper says he also likes hosting the show because he's an adrenaline junkie and gets the opportunity to help people overcome their fears. But this brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen, because I'm sure you'll love them. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.